I saw water proceeding out of the temple from the right side thereof, alleluia, and all men whithersoever the water shall come shall be healed, and shall say, alleluia, alleluia. O give thanks unto the Lord, for he is gracious, because his mercy endureth forever. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. O show thy mercy upon us, alleluia, and grant us thy salvation, alleluia. O Lord, hear my prayer, and let my cry come unto thee. The Lord be with you, and with thy spirit. Let us pray. Graciously hear us, O Lord, Heavenly Father, almighty, everlasting God, that it may please thee to send thy holy angel from heaven to guard and cherish, to protect and visit, and to defend all who dwell in this thy holy habitation, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Alleluia! Christ is risen. The Lord is risen indeed. Alleluia! Almighty God, unto whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of thy Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love thee and worthily magnify thy holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Hear what our Lord Jesus Christ saith. Thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, and with all thy soul, and with all thy mind. This is the first and great commandment, and the second is like unto it. Thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets. Kyrie eleison, Christe eleison, Christe eleison, Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison. Glory be to God on high, and on earth peace, goodwill towards all. We praise thee, we bless thee, we worship thee, we glorify thee, we give thanks to thee for thy great glory. O Lord God, heavenly King, God the Father Almighty, O Lord, the only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, O Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, that takest away the sins of the world, have mercy upon us. Thou that takest away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. Thou that sittest at the right hand of God the Father, have mercy upon us. For thou only art holy, thou only art the Lord, thou only, O Christ, with the Holy Ghost, art most high in the glory of God the Father. Amen. The Lord be with you, and with thy spirit. Let us pray. O God, the King of glory, who hast exalted thine only Son, Jesus Christ, with great triumph unto thy kingdom of heaven, we beseech thee, leave us not comfortless, but send to us thine Holy Ghost to comfort us, and exalt us unto the same place whither our Savior Jesus Christ is gone before, who liveth and reigneth with thee and the same Holy Spirit, one God, world without end. Amen. A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. So when the apostles had come together, they asked Jesus, Lord, is this the time when you will restore the kingdom to Israel? He replied, It is not for you to know the times or periods that the Father has set by his own authority, but you will receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you, and you will be my witnesses in Jerusalem, and all Judea and Samaria, and to the ends of the earth. When he had said this, as they were watching, he was lifted up, and a cloud took him out of their sight. While he was going, and they were gazing upward toward heaven, suddenly two men in white robes stood by them. They said, Men of Galilee, why do you stand looking up toward heaven? This Jesus, who has been taken up from you into heaven, will come in the same way as you saw him go into heaven. they returned to Jerusalem from the mount called Olivet, which is near Jerusalem, a Sabbath day's journey away. When they had entered the city, they went to the room upstairs where they were staying, Peter and John and James and Andrew, Philip and Thomas, Bartholomew and Matthew, James son of Alphaeus, and Simon the Zealot, and Judas son of James. All these were constantly devoting themselves to prayer, together with certain women, including Mary the mother of Jesus, as well as his brothers. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Please join me in saying a portion of Psalm 68. Let God arise and let his enemies be scattered. Let those who hate him flee before him. Let them vanish like smoke when the wind drives it away. As the wax melts at the fire, so let the wicked perish at the presence of God. But let the righteous be glad and rejoice before God. Let them also be merry and joyful. Sing to God, sing praises to his name, exalt him who rides upon the heavens. Yahweh is his name, rejoice before him. Father of orphans, defender of widows, God in his holy habitation. God gives the solitary a home and brings forth prisoners into freedom. But the rebels shall live in dry places. O God, when you went forth before your people, when you marched through the wilderness, the earth shook, and the skies poured down rain at the presence of God, the God of Sinai, at the presence of God, the God of Israel. You sent a gracious rain, O God, upon your inheritance. You refreshed the land when it was weary. Your people found their home in it. In your goodness, O God, you have made provision for the poor. Sing to God, O kingdoms of the earth. Sing praises to the Lord. He rides in the heavens, the ancient heavens. He sends forth his voice, his mighty voice. Ascribe power to God. His majesty is over Israel. His strength is in the skies. How wonderful is God in his holy places, the God of Israel, giving strength and power to his people. Blessed be God. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. A reading from the first letter of Peter. Beloved, do not be surprised at the fiery ordeal that is taking place among you to test you, as though something strange were happening to you. But rejoice in so far as you are sharing Christ's sufferings, so that you may also be glad and shout for joy when his glory is revealed. If you are reviled for the name of Christ, you are blessed, because the Spirit of glory, which is the Spirit of God, is resting on you. Humble yourselves, therefore, under the mighty hand of God, so that he may exalt you in due time. Cast all your anxiety on him, because he cares for you. Discipline yourselves, keep alert. Like a roaring lion, your adversary, the devil, prowls around, looking for someone to devour. Resist him, steadfast in your faith, for you know that your brothers and sisters throughout the world are undergoing the same kinds of suffering. And after you have suffered for a little while, the God of all grace, who has called you to his eternal glory in Christ, will himself restore, support, strengthen, and establish you. To him be the power forever and ever. Amen. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia. I will not leave you comfortless. I go and will come again to you, and your heart shall rejoice. Alleluia. The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to John. Glory be to thee, O Lord. Jesus looked up to heaven and said, Father, the hour has come. Glorify your Son, so that the Son may glorify you, since you have given him authority over all people, to give eternal life to all whom you have given him. And this is eternal life, that they may know you, the only true God, and Jesus Christ, whom you have sent. I glorified you on earth by finishing the work that you gave me to do. So now, Father, glorify me in your own presence with the glory that I had in your presence before the world existed. I have made your name known to those whom you gave me from the world. They were yours, and you gave them to me, and they have kept your word. Now they know that everything you have given me is from you. For the words that you gave to me, I have given to them, and they have received them, and I know in truth that I came from you, and they have believed that you sent me. I am asking on their behalf. I am not asking on behalf of the world, but on behalf of those whom you gave me, because they are yours. All mine are yours, and yours are mine, and I have been glorified in them. And now I am no longer in the world, but they are in the world, and I am coming to you. Holy Father, protect them in your name that you have given me, so that they may be one as we are one. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise be to thee, O Christ. I speak to you in the name of the one true God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
We are getting a rare opportunity today by recognizing the seventh Sunday of Easter. Every year since I came to All Saints, we have transferred celebrating the solemnity of the Ascension to the Sunday following. So we've always used the readings for Ascension Day on this particular Sunday, and that's what I've always preached on. But this year, since I had the platform of being able to come to you directly through your computers and phones on any day of the week, we celebrated Ascension Day at its proper time this past Thursday. And so that gives us the chance to encounter the message of the one and only Sunday of Ascensiontide. I think going forward, we are going to continue celebrating the Ascension on Thursday and the seventh Sunday of Easter afterwards, so we hear the complete message. On Thursday, we focused on that dazzling event known as the Ascension of our Lord, in which we heard the story, twice even, of how Jesus told his disciples that he was going back to the Father. Then he blessed them, lifted up his hands, and was lifted up himself into the heavens. What a spectacle that must have been. The event left them dazed, amazed, and dazzled. They went back to Jerusalem with great joy and were continually in the temple, blessing God. Jesus blessed them, and then they blessed God. In other words, He spoke well of them in a way that conferred a benefit, and they did the same back to him. That is what is meant by the blessing. But just before he left, the book of the Acts of the Apostles tells us that he told the disciples that they would receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon them, and that they would be his witnesses in Jerusalem, in Judea and Samaria, and all the ends of the earth. We read that on Thursday, and we read it again today, because the story of the Ascension is our story. The message of Jesus did not end when he ascended to be once again completely one with the Godhead. Jesus gave his disciples a commission to carry the message to the places where he didn't have time to go. The message of these 10 days of Ascensiontide is to drill into our heads that the baton has been passed to us, and that we have to live our lives in a way that will glorify God, in a way that speaks well of him to confer a benefit to others, just as he confers benefits to us. He blesses us, and we bless him. And we spend these 10 days knowing what our task is, waiting for our equipment to do the task. That is the power we will receive from the Holy Spirit who, as Peter in the letter we read today, will restore, support, strengthen, and establish us. Jesus gave us a task: to help the world know God by being examples of his life on earth, and he equipped us long ago by giving us the Holy Spirit at Pentecost. We will mark that event next week as we celebrate the day of Pentecost. And he wants us to be one when we do it. That he said that they may be one as we are one. He told us that he was of the triune Godhead, and inasmuch as we have been created in God's holy image, Jesus prayed that we too would act as one, just as the triune God acts as one. Well, what does that mean? What does that look like? I think it's interesting the way Jesus commissioned his disciples. He told them to be his witnesses in Jerusalem, in Judea and Samaria, and in all the ends of the earth. Start at home, then move out to your community, and then take it on the road and change the world. The message was never intended to be a secret held by a few believers. It was meant to be shared. But what does that mean, and what does that look like? Does that mean that I should quit my job and start preaching the words of Jesus in the streets? That's why I said you. In my text it said I. Does that mean that you should quit your job and start preaching the words of Jesus in the streets? Of course not. Jesus doesn't want us to stop our lives. He just wants us to incorporate what he taught in our lives, because Jesus came to teach us how to live as the image of God right here in the real world, just as it is, in the midst of all that the world has to offer, both favorable and unfavorable, good and bad. The ascension reminds us that Jesus came into a broken world, and it was still broken when he left. The disciples were nervous when it seemed like he wasn't going to finish what he started. Lord, is this the time that you will restore the kingdom to Israel? No, Jesus said. It is not for you to know the times or the periods when the Father has set by that the Father has set by his own authority. But you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes. When he has come upon you, God isn't going to fix everything that you think needs fixing. God isn't going to use divine intervention to create the utopia that you have imagined this world ought to be. No, you have to live in this world and this universe as it is. And God has given us the tools to live out our short lives on this planet and in this universe so that however life turns out, for you or for anyone, you can live free of anxiety. You can live free of worry, free of anger, full of life and peace. Your job, our job, is to communicate that to everyone. Your job is to treat your sister and brother humans in a way that demonstrates that the love of God is for humankind, a love showing caring and respect. Your job is to go into the world and make a difference where a difference is needed, helping those in need. One day, you might be the one needing help. Your job is to understand and take care of the place of that little piece of creation that God has placed in your path, God's creatures, the environment, understanding the ways of the world and the universe. Your job is to be one, as we, as the Godhead, is one. Your job is to be one. Jesus didn't tell us all to be the same. Jesus told us simply to be whoever we are as the images of God, and to recognize God in everyone and everything else.
I know we would all like a miracle right now. Lord, is it the time when you will restore the kingdom to Israel? We wish God would just wipe out this novel coronavirus to know the times or the periods that the Father has set by his own authority. But God is going to give us what we need to get through it. And he will bless us to figure out how to overcome it. To someone, he will impart wisdom to find a vaccine or a cure or a way to live with it. We will, at some point, be able to resume our normal lives, socializing with each other, going wherever we want, whenever we want, hugging, shaking hands, kissing, and all those intimate things that we can't do right now. No masks, no gloves, no incessant use of hand sanitizer. But for right now, we have been stripped of the conveniences of life. And maybe we can use that time, this time that we have, to spend striving to be as Christ prayed that we would be. There's someone in the world who didn't have the freedom to go anywhere they wanted at any time before this all hit. Now we know a little bit how that feels. There's someone in the world who lives with loneliness and isolation all the time. And now we know a little bit about how that feels. There's someone in the world who is worried about their health. And now we're all worried about our health. We have been stripped of the things that distract us and make us forget that we are all one. We all have the same needs and fears. We're all vulnerable, and we're all broken in some way. The good news of the Ascension is that God came into a broken, imperfect world, and God left it no less broken or imperfect. But he left his people more empowered to live faithful lives in this world, so that when adversity does befall us, we can still bless God. When COVID-19, or anything else for that matter, brings our lives to a halt, we can still trust God to get us through it. When life knocks us down, we get right back up and try again. In his letter to the church, St. Peter couldn't have said more encouraging words for us right now. Humble yourselves. Humble yourselves, therefore, under the mighty hand of God, so that he may exalt you in due time. Cast all your anxiety on him, because he cares for you. Discipline yourselves. Keep alert. Like a roaring lion, your adversary, the devil, prowls around, looking for someone to devour. Resist him, steadfast in your faith, for you know that your brothers and sisters in the world are undergoing the same kinds of suffering. And after you have suffered for a little while, the God of all grace, who has called you to his eternal glory in Christ, will himself restore, support, strengthen, and establish you. To him be the power forever and ever. Amen.
Please stand, and let us now proclaim our faith in the words of the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God. I believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth,
and of all things visible and invisible, and in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of his Father before all worlds, God of God, light of light, very God of very God, begotten, not made, being of one substance with the Father, by him died also for us under Pontius Pilate, and was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered and was buried. And the third day he rose again according to the Scriptures, and ascended into heaven, and sitteth on the right hand of the Father. And he shall come again with glory to judge both the quick and the dead, whose kingdom shall have no end. And I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceedeth from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son together is worshipped and glorified, who spake by the prophets. And I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I acknowledge one baptism for the remission of sins, and I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. In peace, let us pray to the Lord, saying, Lord, have mercy. For all the members of the church, especially the newly initiated, that they welcome God's presence in their lives. For all who flee persecution, that they find safe refuge. For the farmers and ranchers who provide the world's food, that they receive a just reward for their labor. For all who have lost loved ones, especially in this time of pandemic, that they may be comforted by the memories. For the memories of this community of faith, that they may take seriously their baptismal call to service, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. For Michael, our presiding bishop and primate, for Lawrence, Geraldine, Daniel, and Bill, our bishops, for Norman, our rector, Leticia, pastor of the Todos los Santos All Saints Lutheran community, for all bishops, priests, and deacons, and for all the holy people of God, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. For the mission of the church, that in faithful witness it may preach the gospel to the ends of the earth. In the Anglican cycle of prayer, we pray for all the members of the Anglican communion around the world, for the Archbishop of Canterbury, the Most Reverend Justin Welby, and all primates and bishops, for members of the Anglican Consultative Council, the Most Reverend Dr. Josiah Idowu Fearon, Secretary General, and for the staff at the Anglican Communion offices in London and the UN offices in Geneva and New York. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. In the diocesan cycle of prayer, we pray for our companion diocese of Ecuador Central and Torit in the South Sudan, and for the continued rebuilding of our church in Haiti. In the diocesan cycle of prayer, we pray for St. Paul's Roosevelt, Trinity Church Roslyn, St. Luke's Seacliffe, the chapter of Cathedral of the Incarnation, St. Michael and All Angels Seaford, the presiding bishop, and Holy Trinity Valley Stream. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. For Donald, our president, Andrew, our governor, Bill, our mayor, for the leaders of the nations, for those who serve in our armed forces, and for all in authority, that they may serve justice and promote the dignity and freedom of every person, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. For the aged and infirmed, for the widowed and orphans, and for the sick and suffering, especially those on our parish prayer list, for Hyacinth, Christopher, Debbie, George, Ramden, Wilbur, Ginger, Cintra, Roy, Kim, Robert, Darlene, Paul, Mike, Robert, Samuel, Milton, Tyrone, Alola, Harry, Alana, Christopher, Evelyn, Jacqueline, Ruth, Stephen, Howard, Father Charles, Pauline, and Coral. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. For this congregation, that we may be delivered from hardness of heart and show forth thy glory in all that we do. We pray for those persons celebrating birthdays and anniversaries this week. For Adela, Darlene, Rudolph, Dale, Bimal, Steve, William, Mark, and Gregory. And for those celebrating anniversaries, Virgil and Letitia, Bobby and Rabina, and Armand and Tiffany. And for those who are visiting with us for the first time virtually on YouTube, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. We offer special prayers for all who are ill with the coronavirus, for all those who are caring for them, and we give thanksgiving for all who have recovered from it. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. For all who have died in the communion of thy church, remembering especially Joe Sukchan, Angela Goodman, Jeff Cohen, Tishan Moore, Chappelle Moore, Alfred Bechu, Kulsum Khan, Raj Moses, Rudolph Paul, and Gwyneth Harris. Are there others? And those whose faith is known to thee alone, that with all the saints they may have that rest, have rest in that place where there is no pain or grief, but life eternal, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. You are now invited to offer your own intercessions and thanksgiving. Rejoicing in the communion of the ever-blessed Virgin Mary and all the saints, let us commend ourselves and one another and all our life to Christ our God, to thee, O Lord, our God. O Lord Jesus Christ, who after thy resurrection didst manifestly appear to thine apostles, and in their sight didst ascend into heaven to prepare a place for us, grant that being risen with thee, we may lift up our hearts continually to seek thee where thou art, and never cease to serve thee faithfully here on earth, until at last, when thou comest again, thou shalt receive us unto thyself, who livest and reignest with the Father and the Holy Spirit, one God, world without end. Amen. Ye who do truly and earnestly repent you of your sins and are in love and charity with your neighbors, and intend to lead a new life, following the commandments of God and walking from henceforth in his holy ways, draw near with faith, and make your humble confession unto Almighty God, devoutly kneeling. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against thee in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done, and by what we have left undone. We have not loved thee with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry, and we humbly repent. For the sake of thy Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in thy will and walk in thy ways to the glory of thy name. Amen. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, who of his great mercy hath promised forgiveness to all those who, with hearty repentance and true faith, turn unto him, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit keep you in eternal life, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Hear the word of God to all who truly turn to him. Come unto me, all ye that travail and are heavy laden, and I will refresh you. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, to the end that all who believe in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. This is a true saying, and worthy of all to be received, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. So if anyone should sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous, and he is the perfect offering for our sins, and not for ours only, but for the sins of the whole world. The peace of the Lord be always with you, and with thy spirit. What follows is the Lord's Supper. This is God's feast for all of God's people. Wherever you are on your spiritual journey, please know that to God's table you are always welcome. Thine, O Lord, is the greatness and the power and the glory and the victory and the majesty. For all that is in the heaven and in the earth is thine. Thine is the kingdom, O Lord, and thou art exalted as head over all. Blessed art thou, Lord God of all creation. Through thy goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth hath given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. O God, who most wonderfully didst create and yet more wonderfully restore the dignity of humanity, by the mixing and mystery of this water and wine, may we share in the divinity of him who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Amen. Blessed art thou, Lord God of all creation. Through thy goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and the work of human hands. It will become for us our spiritual drink. Blessed be God forever. The Mass this morning is offered to the glory of God in thanksgiving for all his many blessings. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that this sacrifice of yours and mine may be acceptable to God the Father Almighty. May the Lord receive this sacrifice at thy hands to the praise and benefit of his name, both to our benefit and that of all his holy church. O source of all joy, receive our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving. Keep us in the love of Christ and bring us to the vision of his glory through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you and with thy spirit. Lift up your hearts. We lift them up unto the Lord. Let us give thanks unto the Lord our God. It is meet and right so to do. It is very meet, right, and our bounden duty that we should at all times and in all places give thanks unto thee, O Lord, Holy Father, almighty, everlasting God, through thy dearly beloved Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, who, after his glorious resurrection, manifestly appeared to his disciples, and in their sight ascended into heaven to prepare a place for us, that where he is, there we might also be, and reign with him in glory. Therefore, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify thy glorious name, evermore praising thee and saying, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of thy glory. Glory be to thee, O Lord most high. Blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. All glory be to thee, O Lord our God, for that thou didst create heaven and earth, and didst make us in thine own image, and of thy tender mercy didst give thine only Son, Jesus Christ, to take our nature upon him and to suffer death upon the cross for our redemption. He made there a full and perfect sacrifice for the whole world, and did institute, and in his holy gospel command us to continue a perpetual memory of that, his precious death and sacrifice, until his coming again. For in the night in which he was betrayed, he took bread. And when he had given thanks to thee, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me, my Lord and my God. Likewise, after supper, he took the cup of wine. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, Drink ye all of this, for this is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you, and for many for the remission of sins. As oft as ye shall drink it, do this in remembrance of me, my Lord and my God. Wherefore, O Lord and Heavenly Father, we thy people do celebrate and make with these thy holy gifts which we now offer unto thee, the memorial thy Son hath commanded us to make, having in remembrance his blessed passion and precious death, his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, and looking for his coming again with power and great glory. And we most humbly beseech thee, O merciful Father, to hear us, and with thy word and Holy Spirit to bless Jesus Christ. And we earnestly desire thy fatherly goodness to accept this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, whereby we offer and present unto thee, O Lord, ourselves, our souls, and bodies. Grant, we beseech thee, that all who partake of this holy communion may worthily receive the most precious body and blood of thy Son, Jesus Christ, and be filled with thy grace and heavenly benediction. And also that we and all thy whole church may be made one body with him, that he may dwell in us, and we in him, through the same Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom, and with whom, and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Ghost, all honor and glory be unto thee, O Father Almighty, world without end. Amen. And now, as our Savior Christ hath taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Alleluia! Christ, our Passover, is sacrificed for us. Therefore, let us keep the feast. Alleluia. O Lamb of God, that takest away the sins of the world, have mercy upon us. O Lamb of God, that takest away the sins of the world, have mercy upon us. O Lamb of God, that takest away the sins of the world, grant us thy peace. We do not presume to come to this thy table, O merciful Lord, trusting in our own righteousness, but in thy manifold and great mercies. We are not worthy so much as to gather up the crumbs from under thy table, but thou art the same Lord whose property is always to have mercy. Grant us therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of thy dear Son Jesus Christ and to drink his blood, that our sinful bodies may be made clean by his body and our souls washed through his most precious blood, and that we may evermore dwell in him and he in us. Amen. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who taketh away the sins of the world. Happy are we who are called to his supper. Lord, I am not worthy that thou shouldst come under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Since you cannot receive the Blessed Sacrament physically, you are invited to receive Jesus spiritually by making an act of spiritual communion. Please join in the following prayer. My Jesus, I believe that thou art present in the Blessed Sacrament. I love thee above all things, and I desire thee in my soul. Since I cannot now receive thee sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace thee as though thou wert already there, and unite myself wholly to thee. Permit not that I should ever be separated from thee. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, we most heartily thank thee for that thou dost feed us in these holy mysteries with the spiritual food of the most precious body and blood of thy Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and dost assure us thereby of thy favor and goodness towards us, and that we are very members and corporates in the mystical body of thy Son, the blessed company of all faithful people, and are also heirs through hope of thy everlasting kingdom. And we humbly beseech thee, O Heavenly Father, so to assist us with thy grace, that we may continue in that holy fellowship and do all such good works as thou hast prepared for us to walk in, through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with thee and the Holy Ghost be all honor and glory, world without end. Amen. Eternal God, may we who share Christ's banquet be one with him as he is one with thee. We ask this in the name of Jesus Christ, the risen and ascended Lord. Amen. And now may the God of peace, who brought again from the dead our Lord Jesus, the great shepherd of the sheep through the blood of the everlasting covenant, make you perfect in every good work to do his will, working in you that which is well-pleasing in his sight. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost be upon you and remain with you always. Amen. Let us go forth in the name of Christ. Alleluia, alleluia. Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia. O Queen of Heaven, be joyful. Alleluia. Because he whom so meekly thou bearest, alleluia, hath arisen as he promised, alleluia. Pray for us to the Father, alleluia. Rejoice and be glad, O Virgin Mary, alleluia. For the Lord is risen indeed, alleluia. Let us pray. Grant us, O merciful God, protection in our weakness, that we who celebrate the memory of the Holy Mother of God may, through the aid of her intercession, rise again from our sins, through the same Christ our Lord. Amen.